Here, near the Waikato's wild west coast, is where New Zealand Steel's story and our journey to sustainability begins.
Beneath my feet are what's conservatively estimated to be 600 million tonnes of iron sand, the product of countless eruptions at Mount Taranaki,
swept here by wind and tide over the last 2 million years. Now, thanks to some clever scientific Kiwi ingenuity, it's the raw material in the high-quality steel made at New Zealand Steel's Glenbrook plant. New Zealand Steel is the only steel manufacturer anywhere in the world to have mastered the sand-to-steel process.
A lot of history has been in New Zealand looking into iron and steel making. As soon as the settlers landed on the Whetū Peninsula behind us, they started looking at the iron sand and trying to turn it into steel.
Let's define what we mean by sustainability. New Zealand Steel believes it has three equally valid aspects: environmental, economic, and social. And we must provide for the future of all of them through truly robust processes and practices founded on integrity.
At a time when sustainability has become the buzzword across the country and people are talking about it, New Zealand Steel has for many, many years actually been living that whole sustainability concept.
Of course, sustainability is a very popular word these days, and some industries are more deserving of the tag than others. But you're about to see how New Zealand Steel can justifiably claim to be a long way down the road towards sustainability. At each step of the steelmaking process, the product it produces, and beyond. Since the 1970s, it has been New Zealand Steel's vision and policy to minimise waste and reduce the impact of its operations on the environment. Jeremy Batchelor is New Zealand Steel's chief chemist and set up their environmental laboratory in 1976.
We started thinking about environmental banks when we first started building the company. We've been doing it ever since, and we will continue to do it for as long as we're actually here. Why do we do it? It's the right thing to do for the environment.
The first step in environmental responsibility begins when iron sand is extracted at Waikato River's North Head deposits near Waiuku. To minimise environmental impact, electric-powered conveyor belts and underground slurry pumps are used to move sand 18 kilometres to the steel plant. This system was very costly to install, but avoids using trucks. The enormous environmental impact of fully laden trucks travelling every 3 minutes every day of the year was not an acceptable transportation solution. Of the sand that is mined, 25% is extracted, with the remaining 75% of the sand being returned to where it came from and planted with marram grass and then pines, leaving virtually no trace of mining.
New Zealand Steel currently generates around about 600,000 tonnes of waste products a year. Up to 80% of those materials are recycled back into co-products for various use.
Hot waste gases produced by the multi-hearth furnaces in the iron-making process are recycled back through a cogeneration boiler, which can actually then generate up to 70% of New Zealand Steel's own needs.
So basically, we only have to purchase on the open market 30% of our power requirements. New Zealand Steel utilises roughly 1 million tonnes of water every single day. 99% of this water is actually recycled internally within our own processes. We only discharge about 1% of this material after it is treated and cleaned. Some of this water is discharged onto an oyster bed. The oysters are tested regularly and meet the New Zealand criteria for healthy oysters.
The biggest percentage of the company's capital investment in environmental control is in the improvement of the quality of its emissions into the atmosphere, with more than 3 million cubic metres of waste gas being cleaned each hour the steel plant is working at full capacity.
New Zealand Steel's sustainability focus extends beyond mining and production. Because of its strength, steel is an extremely efficient way to build. You need less steel than other structural materials. Plus, it has a long life and is 100% recyclable. In fact, steel is one of the most recyclable materials in the world. It can be recycled over and over again without loss of properties or quality. Products made from recycled steel are equally as good as products made from virgin steel. This makes steel a unique building material.
The steel is fantastic for me because it's so versatile. Just the nature of it allowed me to create something that I think's, you know, a one-off design that you couldn't actually build out of any other material.
Steel is also a healthy material to use in homes. It's non-toxic and does not leach chemicals or toxic gases. It's considered non-allergenic and mould or mildew will not grow on it. The Asthma Foundation of New Zealand has awarded Access Steel for Framing the Sensitive Choice logo, recognising its contribution to healthy homes. Beacon Pathway, a research organisation developing sustainable housing, uses New Zealand Steel's products in creating Now Homes.
For Beacon Pathway and the design and construction of the now home in Rotorua, steel was an easy choice. The advantage with using New Zealand steel product is we know where it comes from, we know how it's manufactured, and we have good information on its environmental credentials. The key benefits of steel we would see as being its durability, much lower waste, and the ability to take that waste back into the production stream. Ultimately, it's infinitely recyclable. The data we had showed that pre-coated steel had the lowest environmental footprint of any cladding product.
And what of New Zealand Steel's impact on the local area? The Glenbrook plant is a big operation by any measure. In fact, it's the biggest single-site employer in New Zealand with over 1,300 workers, and it contributes 1% or over $2 billion a year to the GDP.
Waiuku was a country village serving largely a farming community, and along came the steel mill.
New Zealand Steel is solidly entrenched in the social fabric of the Franklin District.
It's continued supporting local businesses. They buy locally in Waiuku in the Franklin area.
The future of Franklin is in no doubt involved with New Zealand Steel, and New Zealand Steel are major players in the future direction of the economy of this district.
New Zealand Steel takes its responsibility as a resident of the Franklin District and broader South Auckland community very seriously. New Zealand Steel supports a number of initiatives, all of which make its community a better place to live. Two key New Zealand-wide programs are RIDER, a youth driver awareness program, and DARE, a youth drug resistance program. Both work to warn children about these high-risk social areas. The New Zealand Steel annual beach cleanup at Kariotahi Beach attracts over 300 people, who remove several tonnes of rubbish from 16 kilometres of our magnificent west coast shoreline. But perhaps the most visible symbol of our involvement in the local community is Franklin, the centre, where locally made steel construction material showcases a wealth of local culture, art and information. And while New Zealand Steel is very active in the local community, the interests and welfare of individual employees naturally takes top priority.
We have a goal of zero harm, and there's only one way that's going to be achieved, and that is through constant and day-to-day attention to the basics and really embracing the whole person that comes to work.
The company's commitment to staff and safety has been recognised in numerous ways, including being awarded an ACC Health and Safety Award in 2007. New Zealand Steel's efforts to make steel production as sustainable as possible have drawn international recognition. The Hatch Report ranks it as one of the world's top companies for best practice in energy efficiency and consumption. It has ISO 14001 accreditation for its environment management and policy, one of the few New Zealand companies to achieve this. And the Ministry for the Environment has awarded New Zealand Steel for its co-product waste minimisation program. While these awards are gratifying, the story doesn't end here. New Zealand Steel continues to develop ways to further its already comprehensive sustainability journey for an organisation and product that's Kiwi to the core.